And India has conveyed its position vis-a-vis Pakistan's offer of foreign secretary-level talks, that it accepts the invitation to visit Islamabad, but made it clear the discussion should focus first on the more pressing aspects of the Jammu and Kashmir situation. In the latest response, MEA has underlined the importance of bringing to justice all those guilty in Pakistan for Mumbai terror attack of 2008 and Pathankot airbase attack, while stressing that a visit to Islamabad should provide the opportunity to receive a briefing from Pakistan's foreign secretary on the progress in this regard.
India has toughened its stand vis-a-vis Pakistan after rejecting Pakistan's offer to hold talks on Kashmir and proposing talks on terrorism instead. It says it is looking forward to discussing with Pakistan the earliest possible vacation of Pakistan's illegal occupation of the Indian state of Jammu and Kashmir.
Foreign Secretary also said that he looks forward to discussing with his counterpart the earliest possible vacation of Pakistan's illegal occupation of the Indian state of Jammu and Kashmir.
Foreign Secretary S. Jaishankar has expressed government's keenness to discuss that aspect in his letter to his Pakistani counterpart, Ezaz Ahmed Chaudhry. Foreign Secretary has conveyed to Chaudhry that while he accepts his invitation to visit Islamabad, the discussions should focus first on the more pressing aspects of the Jammu and Kashmir situation, that include cessation of cross-border terrorism by Pakistan aimed at Jammu and Kashmir, ending incitement to violence and terrorism from Pakistan and Jammu and Kashmir, detaining and prosecuting internationally recognized Pakistani terrorist leaders, closing down of Pakistani terrorist camps, and denying safe havens to terrorists in Pakistan who have escaped Indian law. India maintains that Pakistan's refusal to grant permission to a UN human rights team to visit Pakistan-occupied Kashmir indicates the state of affairs in the region. Ministry of External Affairs said that the residents of POK are India's own people and the government will do everything necessary for their welfare.
MEA will do what it has to do because, after all, the people of Pakistan-occupied Kashmir are also our people.
Meanwhile, a political tug of war continues on the issue. While Congress leader Digvijay Singh committed a gaffe by describing Kashmir as India-occupied Kashmir, Information and Broadcasting Minister Venkaiah Naidu came down heavily on the Congress over its leaders speaking in different voices on Jammu and Kashmir and in the process strengthening Pakistan's claims.
India-occupied Kashmir ho ya Pakistan-occupied Kashmir ho, agar yahan par vishwas logon ke man mein kaim karna hai, to baatcheet ke jariye se hi ho sakta hai. प्रधानमंत्री जी के इस जो कन्फ्रंटेशनिस्ट एक बयान आया है इससे हालात सुधरेंगे नहीं बिगड़ेंगे
वही द कांग्रेस लीडर्स आर ट्राइंग टू एग्जोनरेट पाकिस्तान व्हिच इज एडिंग अबेटिंग फंडिंग ट्रेनिंग टेररिस्ट इज एवरीबॉडी इज नॉलेज पाकिस्तान इज फिशिंग द ट्रबल्ड वाटर्स ऑफ जम्मू एंड कश्मीर.
All in all, India has lobbed the ball in Pakistan's court on foreign secretary-level talks between the two countries. It is for Pakistan to take a call on India's offer of discussing cross-border terrorism and vacation of Pakistan's illegal control over POK. With inputs from Amritpal Singh in Delhi, DD News.